This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your hosts, Casey and Jay.
There'll be food and drink and ghosts. And perhaps even a few murders.
Widespread investigation.
You're all
invited. Orients and hospitals has concluded that the unburied dead are coming back to life and seeking human victims.
And he said, "Oh, it's late. Why did we start so late?"
Hey everybody, welcome to the show. This is Openly Hostile Opinions. I'm Jay. That's Casey.
What's up everyone? How are you doing?
And today we have a special guest with us.
How are you doing, Terry?
Not too bad. How are you guys doing?
We're doing all right. So you're gonna here to talk about some stuff, drink some beer with us. It's our first guest, so we're pretty excited. We got some stuff planned for you. We're going to tell you a little bit about Terry. Terry's going to tell you a little bit of himself, then we're going to play it a game at the end. Just see how things go. First guest, it's going to be exciting.
First guest on our Halloween special.
Yes.
Spooky.
Hopefully no ghosts come out of the walls and rape us or anything. But
if you're watching or listening to us on a podcast, you may want to go to YouTube for this one so you can get to see us play the game and see us in our ridiculous outfits.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, it's Halloween. We have to dress up for it.
Either or, our outfits are god-awful.
That's all right. So today for our... We have one of my personal favorites. We have Victory Brewing Company's Hop Devil.
Oh yeah!
It's despite the name, it's not super hoppy compared to most IPAs nowadays. It's pretty weak, but it's got a great flavor profile, a lot of citrus to it.
Yeah, anything Victory makes is pretty good. I'm excited. It's only 6% down from 8 last week. So
okay, I didn't think this whole mask thing through.
It's not working out too well.
No, the whole drinking with the mask thing on is not at all working.
Yeah, that's it's hoppy, but not as hoppy as the previous stuff.
It's got a great flavor profile. It's one of my favorites. It's an American style IPA instead of a English IPA.
Yeah, that makes my balls suck up into my chest a little bit. You like that, Terry, at all?
Oh, yeah.
Really? You like hoppy beers?
It's not too bad.
Yeah.
We're going to go, I think, with the 4 carved jack-o'-lanterns out of 5 on this one.
4 carved jack-o'-lanterns out of 5? Yeah, I'd say that's a pretty good thing. I'd say it's just as good as the last two. Well, I don't know, were they? Yeah, they were very hoppy, so I'd say it's pretty good. I like it. I'd take it home to mother.
All right, so I figure since we got our special guest here, we ought to let him go ahead and... hop on the mic and tell us some stories. He's got a couple of Halloween stories for us.
So, Terry, go ahead and tell us about this Halloween story.
The one time that comes to mind most of all,
Here, get up on your mic a little bit there, Terry. There you go.
Sorry, guys.
Suck it like a dick.
Went to this Halloween house.
Uh-huh.
And, of course, you know, I got pretty ripped up before I went. Well, I went with these two smoking hot women and sad thing is it wasn't very scary because when we were going through we got about halfway through and what the hell is his name, Leatherface?
Oh yeah,
Chainsaw Massacre. Well, he grabbed a hold of the one girl's arm and wouldn't let go. And she's screaming and carrying on like there's no fucking tomorrow.
Yeah.
So I, you know, and she's hollering for me to help her, so I turn around and I mean it wasn't exactly the best experience in the world because it was kind of hard for people to get scared and fucking, you know, trying to kick Leatherface's ass.
Wait, did you hit him or anything?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I went fucking ballistic on him. It's like, you motherfucker. You.
Did you get in trouble at all? Or?
Oh, yeah. I got escorted out pretty quickly.
So, I yeah.
So you hit the performer.
I hit the performer.
Poor bastards.
I think you're the first person I've ever met that's went to a haunted house, and the people that made the haunted house were probably more afraid than the people.
And the people were of them. Yeah.
I remember reading somewhere, actually, that's a common problem. People hit the performers all the time. They think they can handle it.
Yeah.
You know, and some jackass comes at you wielding a fake chainsaw, and, you know, the fight or flight response kicks in. Yeah. And you just go now, fucking ape shit and kick his ass.
Now, did you hurt him at all?
Or
did you just hit him a couple times, or did you take the boots to him? Like,
no, I didn't let up. I totally fucking went for the
You're
lipstick.
Like, where's my money? Where's my money?
I mean, it was fun, you know what I mean? To me, he took it too seriously.
Yeah, how long ago was this?
Oh, God, just at least 15 years ago.
Oh, man.
I mean, I don't think them people forgot me. It was fucked up. You know.
Did you at least get some pussy afterwards?
No. That's the thing that sucks. Oh. No?
You defended that bitch's honor?
Yeah.
She didn't even give you not even a celebratory blowjob?
Yeah, man. Oh, that's like fucking Mario Brothers, man. You go through all those castles trying to save that bitch and she won't even sleep with you. Yeah, it's like, bitch, you know what I've been through?
You know, you ever think Mario maybe got frustrated and just raped Toad?
Oh, yeah, probably.
Like, your princess is another castle. Come here, motherfucker.
You mind? It's going in dry. Actually, with that little toadstool head, that's probably what it sounds like when he penetrated. You ever feel mushroom? It's very soft and squishy, so, you know.
Oh, you felt the mushroom once or twice.
Yeah, I've never been to prison, so no, I haven't. I won't stand for this.
Well, when they get done with you, you won't be standing for a while.
Yeah, that's definitely right. Yeah, they have to be duct tape my ass together so my intestines don't fall on my asshole.
Oh, my God.
So,
oh, jeez.
So you didn't get any pussy after you beat up Leatherface?
No.
God, man, what do you have to do to get pussy?
I'm Jesus. Telling you, holy fuck. I thought if anything, that would do it.
Yeah,
now,
really.
Now, were you high or were you on any other drugs?
Oh, I was ripped.
Really?
Real bad.
Like everything under the sink.
So, yeah, pretty much anything you can imagine.
So him coming at you probably wasn't like Leatherface. It was like, I'm going to die. I'm in another dimension.
Remember, you are not supposed to drink the bong water.
How about it? Doesn't work too well.
Oh, no, every time I go to a haunted house, I'm just going to be thinking of you fucking charging at someone.
I mean, I jumped and shit, you know, when we were going through. But then when this guy grabbed hold of her and he wouldn't let go, and she's like, this fucker won't let it go. It's like, I just snapped.
You're like, I'm raping you tonight, bitch. No one else.
That's pretty fucked up, though.
Yeah.
Needless to say, I never got to go back to that haunted house again.
Yeah, I bet they, yep. That's
Hey, have you guys heard about these blackout haunted houses they're doing?
Mm-mm.
It's like an excuse to have softcore porn kind of going on. They do these blackout haunted houses, especially.
Really? Do you know where any of these?
I think they're more prevalent on the West Coast, but they set up these haunted houses, and it's not even a haunted house, really. They change them every year, so you don't know from year to year what you're getting into, but you walk through the whole thing, and like, you have to dig through fake vomit, and there's, like, naked chicks that, you know, they accuse you of raping her.
Naked chicks and vomit sounds like another Two Girls, One Cup video. Yeah.
Like, the one guy went through one, and they had, like, all these fake used condoms all over the floor. You had to walk through and find keys, and there's this naked lady chained to the floor, and you had to get by, and then at the end, the ringmaster or whoever's running the show... it was basically accusing you of raping her and shit like that. It's supposed to be a new dimension in horror.
Wow, so it's like when I was 13.
Yeah. So not only are you scared, but you're oddly aroused.
I'm oddly aroused right now, you know. I might have to put some cold water on this thing.
Well, you know, you do have the hop devil.
Yeah, the hop devil.
That'll make you aroused. This is one of my favorite beers.
It is pretty good, I gotta admit. It is pretty good.
It's not a strong IPA. It's definitely a session beer.
Yeah, usually IPAs are like 8%. I saw this one was like 6 something, so that's pretty low.
Well, it's just not. It's not a slap in the face with the hops.
Nah, that's pretty good though. I like it.
All right, so you got anything else for us there, Terry?
There's another time I can think of. I went to this Halloween party.
Oh boy!
And big bowl of punch. Of course, you know they put something.
So it's spiked buns.
There was a pube hair in it.
I don't think that's what he's getting.
Yeah, I know.
I'll tell you what, it was pretty weird because, you know, everybody's in costume.
Yeah.
And, you know, your mind is just.
Oh, my God, like, dude.
Kind of wondering.
That guy we were talking about last week probably ran in. He's like, the place is on fire. I got to save the dog.
That guy did look like he didn't sleep for about a month.
So go on, Terry.
But it's pretty cool because, I mean, the one guy I knew, him and his girlfriend were dressed as Raggedy Ann and Andy. And he's like this. And
oh, God.
Like, oh, fuck. I got to get out of here.
Yeah, just the movements just, like that.
I've done some
recreational drugs in my life before.
No way.
And just the way you move, I'm getting flashbacks right now.
Just like, I don't like this.
Did they tell anyone there was drugs in the punch?
Oh yeah.
Oh,
oh you knew it.
Oh yeah. So he's like
in the door, you know,
like Terry the Stoner here.
And then, you know, a little bit of everything else.
Yeah. See, I don't remember.
Was there like rainbow sheen on the top of the punch bowl?
That's what it felt like.
Yeah, I don't remember any Halloween parties like that. I just I don't think I've ever. Did you ever have a Halloween party where you fucking were so fucked up off of stuff?
I've had plenty of parties where I've been. I don't remember part of them, but I don't remember any of them specifically being a Halloween party.
I know, because that is just the worst idea. Like, you already see shit when you're on drugs. Let's all dress up like freaks.
I mean, the thing is, that punch, each cup of punch had like 3 hits of brown acid in it.
Oh my God.
Getting like 3 to each cup you drank. Well, they made sure everybody had one. Glass bowl when you went in, if there was any left, you were able to drink more. But it's like, I...
You know what would help this costume party? A big old bag of ketamine.
Was this after or before you beat up Leatherface?
Oh, this was way before.
Oh, okay. So I was going to say, man, if I was at that party, I'd be like, Leatherface, come, man. I'm going to beat that motherfucker.
Jeez.
Yeah,
fucking hearing seeing sounds and shit.
Yeah, that's oh man, that sounds like a good time, very good time.
I hope y'all like that sound because I'm gonna play that shit constantly.
I know because we're never gonna use it again for like a whole another year.
365 days. Oh jeez. Speaking of Halloween, I want to talk to you guys, man. We all know Japan's fucking weird.
Yes, and I love it.
They are fucking weird. So in true Japanese fashion, they have some really fucking weird ghosts. So I want to tell you guys about a few of the choice ones I found today that are pretty good. I'm going to do my best to pronounce these names, but because I don't sit and masturbate to anime, I can't sit here and tell you I know how to pronounce them.
Just
all.
Drop a fork on the floor and it'll sound like their names.
Ding dong, ding dong.
Yep.
All right. So our first Japanese ghost, which they call yokai, is a shirimi. A shirimi is a man with an eye for an asshole.
I thought it was a Japanese pastry.
Sounds like something you get at the China buffet.
Yeah.
Right next to the imitation crab meat.
Yeah, I'm craving those shirimis.
The fucking rangoons. All right, so the story goes, a samurai was walking down a road at night when a man in a kimono stopped and asked him for like a moment of his time, right? So the samurai stopped because he's a goddamn gentleman. And to his horror, the man removed his kimono, bent over, like drop trowel, bare-assed it, and he had a big glittering eyeball where the sun doesn't shine.
That's so there literally is truth to my big brown eye.
Apparently. There was no mention whether the eye was brown or not, but I would have to assume so.
God, man, I wonder if it ever has to, like, Visine that eye. Shit probably gets dry down there.
It didn't say whether it had eyelids or not.
What was it called again? Mashimi?
Shirimi.
Shirimi. My shirimi.
Sounds like something that's made with shrimp.
Yeah, my shirimi.
My shirimi.
Oh, so perfect.
And the funniest part is, like, it's not malicious at all. It just is there. It's a thing you see.
Now, probably, I'm going to try that once. Probably I'll get on the sex offender list or something.
I didn't even think of that shit. Searching for these, I'm probably on some list.
Probably.
Jesus. All right, so here's our next one, man. These ones are like one of my favorites. These ones are called Kamatichi.
Why do all these sound like 80s socks?
Kamatichi, I think it is. Which literally means sickle weasel.
Oh, great.
Okay, so there's three weasel brothers who go around cutting off people's legs. Because, you know, as you do.
Nah.
So
what? Some legs, man.
Here's the thing, though. The first weasel knocks someone down. The second one cuts off his legs. And the third one sews up the wounds and applies medication.
What? What are these Canadian weasels?
Yeah.
Like, hey, I gotta take your legs. I'm so sorry, though.
You can come over to my house and fuck my sister.
I like that motherfucker. They ride on the wind and move so quickly that one moment you have legs and the next you just don't.
That is so... Why, I just don't get why they fix you up.
I don't know. You know what, though? The first two are assholes, but the third one's okay with me.
Yeah. He's Canadian.
He's
probably.
Cool, man.
Yeah, he's probably Canadian. He's like, I'm so sorry.
You know what it's like? It's like a lot of those families where you have one member who tries to make up for all the dumb shit the rest of them do.
Uh-huh.
I mean, poor weasel number three just gets left holding the bag, you know?
Oh, man.
It's like, God damn it, my fucking brother. I'm so sorry.
He's like, he does this a lot. He has problems. He just got out of the ward, you know, whatever.
Please don't press charges. He didn't mean it. I swear to God. Here, let me slap some salve on you.
Here's your legs back, and it's in one of those Ziplocs where it turns pink so you can tell that it's sealed.
My question, though, is what the fuck do they do with the legs when they get them?
I don't.
You're going to notice a theme here. Legs seem to be a thing.
Oh, God.
All right, so our next one is called a Jorogumo. Jorogumo. Jorogumo is a spider woman. It's a giant spider with the ability to take the form of a beautiful lady. And in some of the stories, the top half's human, the lower torso is that of the spider. And what they do is they seduce men, wrap them up in their web, poison them, and eat them. But here's where it gets really fucked up. In some of the stories, she appears as a woman holding a baby who asks random men to hold it, as you do.
Apparently. That's so fucking weird.
When they do, you discover the baby is made up of thousands of spider eggs, which burst open.
Who thinks of this shit?
Yeah, I don't know, but you didn't feel like sleeping tonight, did you?
No.
Enjoy that itchy feeling right now.
I'm getting one already because of this fucking afro.
Shut up, Cap.
I won't stand for this.
All right, so the next one here is Kekai, which literally means blood clot.
Oh, God. If this is going where I think it's going.
As if it isn't tough enough in Japan to give birth. In Japan, you might just give birth to a demon monster type of thing. They have a bunch of them. They're called Sankeis. There are a bunch of different kinds, but the worst of them is called the Kekai. Basically, instead of giving birth to a baby, the lady gives birth to a small monkey-like creature with hair that grows backwards and two tongues. One's red, one's white. I don't know what the significance of that is. I have no idea. But what happens is when you squeeze them out of your cooter hole, they immediately run off covered in blood straight out of the vagina in fluids and try to escape. Now, you need to try to stop them from escaping, because if they succeed, they'll return later on to kill their mother by burrowing straight through the floorboards up through mom.
Oh, my God. What, do they come through the belly button?
Yeah, straight up through the floorboards, through the bed, through mom.
Oh,
and you
my
think
God.
Your kids are assholes.
It's like alien surprise.
Yeah, literally.
Oh, my. Who comes up with this shit, man?
Japanese people.
Obviously, they were at a party and someone spiked the punch.
They saw Terry there. They're like, oh, my God, a little hairy monkey boy. It's coming to kill mom.
Oh, God, who comes up with this shit?
Jesus Christ, you need a lozenge over there.
Yeah, maybe. It's a spider monkey.
Well, it's coming to get you.
Yeah.
Don't, you know, childbirth is bad enough, but then you have to worry about, you know, giving birth to some creature that's going to run off and try to kill you in your sleep, you know?
Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah, exactly. But what, does it say anything about if you do catch it? Do you get a prize?
not dying is a pretty good prize, I think.
Oh, okay. Because, like, I'd say, like, it sort of sucked keeping that thing around. Like, people come over to visit, and you're just like, oh, that's my two-tongued spider monkey. Like, just ignore him.
Dude, log in a little fucking, like, one of those aquariums. Put a lid on it. Be like a turtle.
Yeah.
poke it once in a while. Don't tap on the glass. It makes it mad.
Yeah, or like when you catch it, it's like, surprise, you get, you know, a free month of car insurance.
Jesus Christ. It'd be like the Geico gecko.
Just fucking kills you.
All right, so our next one here is an obumi. An obumi is a woman who dies just before, during, or shortly after childbirth. I would guess it's because they were worried to death about giving birth to a little monkey that's going to kill them in their sleep.
Fuck yeah, man.
I would make me, you know, be a little concerned. So why not, you know, give birth to a murder monkey, you die. So whatever. I don't know if the two are interrelated or not. But her spirit's too worried about her baby to pass on peacefully, so she turns into a ghost. If the mother dies but the baby survives, she'll wander into stores and homes to try to buy necessities for her child, paying with handfuls of dead leaves. So I guess you go buy some Huggies with a with a pile of rotted leaves.
Oh man, what the fuck, dude?
Dead leaves in the dirty ground when I know you're not around.
Five pine needles, please. All I got is maple leaves. Get out.
Oh yeah. So if the both the mother and the child die, the Boomy will appear in the dark, rainy nights as a woman carrying a child and crying for help. She then passes her baby on to somebody willing to help. I'm noticing a pattern here.
No.
But the baby turns out to be a rock that grows heavier and heavier until the victim is crushed under its weight. The moral of the story here is if anybody tries to hand you a baby while you're in Japan, you might want to go ahead and run home and hide under your covers and pray for a while.
Yeah, that's just fucking... What is it with their obsession, like childbirth?
Did you ever give birth?
Fuck no.
I'm a parent.
I took a couple of shits that felt like I did. Oh. That was after a lot of cheese I ate.
What the hell?
Oh shit, a baby came out.
Yeah, you can't. I think they're kind of scared of giving birth in Japan, man.
Fuck, yeah, man. I'm scared of birth as it is. Like, you know, just seeing videos and shit in Japan. Fuck that shit.
I have kids, man. I was in the room when they came out. You know, I'll tell you, it's pretty horrifying.
Oh my god, yeah. Oh Jesus, like, oh, thank God I was born a man. Thank fucking God.
The miracle of childbirth, right there.
Ugh.
You know, quick little aside here. You know, when we were having my first kid, we had to do with the emergency C-section route because she was coming out wrong, and I was kicked out of the room because they had to operate immediately. I'm kind of glad for that, but then they're bringing me in to see my kid. She was just born. It was my first kid. I'm overwhelmed, and they're bringing me in, and they say, "Whatever you do, don't look over there." And you know damn well.
Fuck yeah, you are.
You know damn well because they said, don't look over there. I looked over there. Well, what there was my wife laying with her insides splayed open, laying on the table.
Then Terry runs in all tripping on ass. He's like, ooh, hors d'oeuvres.
Somebody get the jump rope in. You know, and let me tell you one thing. You know how they always show you on in science class that innards are pink? They are not. They are gray.
Ugh. Yeah.
I know. I know my wife inside and out.
Oh, that is.
Thank you.
Thank God I don't have kids. I ain't going through that shit.
it's something. I wouldn't trade them for the world, but Jesus. All right, so moving on, we have our next Japanese ghost is called the Itan Mamon, and the Itan Mamon is a sentient scarf or like a roll of cotton that just kind of flies around in the wind at night, like wandering all over the place,
like a homeless person.
Yeah, which sounds pretty cool and all. Like, oh, it's like that bag in American Beauty. It's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
Oh, that fucking movie's crazy. That movie's crazy.
You guys seen that shit with the little plastic bag? Yeah. I'd imagine it's something like that. But here's where this asshole comes along. If it sees you, it'll either wrap itself around your neck and choke you to death or suffocate you.
Oh.
So you can, like, go
Are you allowed to masturbate while this is happening?
Ask the singer from NXS. I feel bad about that one.
Oh, it's all right. We have no souls.
Hey, you got shoes there on the bottom of your feet.
Yeah.
So anyway, you know, that just scares the crap out of me. You know, you could be like walking to go get dinner at some restaurant and you see, oh, look, it's some piece of cotton. Fuck!
I know. You'd be like, it's the most beautiful.
Well, fuck, I'm dead.
Nah.
You know.
Oh, good. I can't believe some of this shit exists.
And here's one that if anybody's heard of any Japanese ghosts, they probably heard of this one. Kuchisaki Ona is what it, or Ona. Is it's more of a modern thing. It's also known as the slip mouth woman. You probably heard of this one. They even made a movie about it. It was a pretty decent movie too. But anyway, she's a woman who wears a medical mask and asks kids if she's pretty. She is, so the kid will say yes. Well, that's when she removes her mask and she reveals that her mouth's been slit open on both sides in a Glasgow grin. You know, like Joker style.
So it's like Melina from Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, kinda, except for it's
I'm going to bite your dick off.
Except for it's a human mouth, but it's all, yeah. You know, it's cut. And she asks the kid if they think she's pretty now. If the child says no, she cuts you in half.
Oh, great.
If the kid says yes, she slits her mouth exactly like hers. You know, so
it's a fucking lose-lose.
So fuck
lose.
You.
Yeah. Jesus Christ.
According to some stories, though, if you answer noncommittally, like, you look okay, or you look all right, she'll let you live. I would not recommend trying that with an American woman, however. You might rather take the Glasgow grin.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, you look okay. I know, you like, are gonna die.
I know. It sort of started off like, I was like, this is like America women. They're always asking if you're pretty, and you can never win.
Yeah, well, if you say that to an American woman, you look all right.
Your soul is mine.
Okay, now here's where things are going to get real fun. Because this is Halloween. and Japan's fucking weird as hell. Because this is the land of used panty vending machines and tentacle porn. Of course, they have a bunch of ghosts.
Used panty machines?
You never heard of that?
No.
But
get out
neither
of
one
town.
Of you. Get out of town.
Trademark Jane Casey.
Well, they have, in certain parts of Japan, they have vending machines with girls used panties in them.
Oh my God. Are they stained? You were thinking the same thing. Yeah. I'm not the only one.
I used to think I was the normal one, apparently. Apparently, I am mistaken.
I wonder, like, oh, I gotta look at, we gotta cover this again, Jay. Because I am looking into this. Like, I am going to look
all right,
into
well,
it.
Well, coming soon, we're going to have a weird Japan section of our show, I guess.
Oh, use machine. That's so great.
Well, anyway, because they have that in tentacle porn. Of course, they have a bunch of ghosts that live in a bathroom.
Oh, man. It's so strange how detailed these are. It's like in America, we have, like, the boogeyman.
Yeah, we
like,
got
the lives
boogeyman.
In your closet, and if you don't behave, he'll get you. But this is like, we'll cut you in half. Do I look pretty? I don't fucking know.
That's a pretty hellish, hellaciously creative urban myth, though, I gotta say.
Yeah, it is. They're pretty creative.
All right, so let's talk about potty ghosts.
Oh, great. These are where all the panties come from. All
right, we've got the Tiki Tiki. She's the spirit of a girl trapped on some train tracks and was cut in half by an oncoming train. Now she crawls around looking for other people to share her fate. In some stories, she cuts them in half with a scythe. In other versions, she twists her leg off like a toddler with, like, a grasshopper, you know? Come here!
Oh, my God.
If you're going to lose your legs, I'd rather take the weasel guys. At least they patch you up afterwards.
Yeah, no.
You'll see this seems to be a thing. Yeah. I don't know what it is with the legs. I don't know what they do with them. They, like, eat them like drumsticks?
Probably.
So, anyway, we'll get to the bathroom part. She wanders into bathroom stalls and asks people who are pooping if they know where her legs are. If you don't answer with the correct answer, which is the Mishin Railway, she cuts your legs up. I don't know how the fuck you get from going on a train track and losing your legs to going to haunting bathrooms.
Maybe like, someone just likes trains and pooping.
Like, you thought Moaning Myrtle was bad from Harry Potter. At least she doesn't murder your ass if you make fun of her.
Yeah, it's a strange thing with legs. I don't know if they have a shortage of legs in Japan.
There must be. There must be some sort of a leg problem.
Yeah, it's just, you know, probably those little spider monkeys running around, you know, like, who fucking knows? Stealing your shit.
This one might be my favorite on the list coming up here. Oh, shit, I missed one from the other one. We'll have to come back to this after we get done with the bathroom ghosts, because this one's just fucking batshit crazy. All right, so anyway, we'll go to the bathroom ghosts. We'll finish that first. We have one called the Akamanto. So you're taking a crap in a Japanese public bathroom. It's got to be public. I don't know why they specified. And you hear, like, this disembodied voice ask you, would you like red toilet paper or blue toilet paper?
What is this, the Matrix?
I guess. So say, Casey, you're sitting there and you decide you're going to take the red toilet paper.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this ghost is going to appear and rip your skin to shreds, and then that's your red toilet paper.
Oh, my God.
So you're effectively red. And say, Terry, you're in there dropping a stink pickle, and you hear the voice, and it says that, you know, would you like the blue paper or the red paper? So you go for the blue paper. Then it strangles you to death, so you turn blue, and then that's the blue paper.
I'd rather be strangled, because at least I can get a nut off before I die.
Shoot now, it off.
You're like, fuck that shit.
In some other versions of the story, if you say any other color, it'll drag you straight off to hell. So it's a damned if you do, damned if you don't situation. But in some versions, if you say yellow, you'll make out okay. Because it'll just piss on you.
Okay.
So, I mean, some people are just getting a chub right now, thinking about the thought of some ghost pissing on them. I'm not here to judge.
I like how Terry's the stoner here, and he's like the only rational one. He's like, I don't want any of those. Me and you were like deciding, we're like, yeah, why can't we just be like, I don't want any of those? Be like, I'll use my hand.
Given the option, I would take getting peed on. I'm just saying.
Yeah, I probably would too.
I mean, if you're ever presented in that situation, at least say yellow. Maybe you'll get pissed on. Maybe you get dragged to hell. But at least you got a chance.
Nah.
Jeez. What would it do to you if you said you got black? You know, I want black toilet paper.
Probably set you on fire and then fucking barbecue you or some shit.
All right, here's one that's actually sort of helpful, and I kind of wish they would make their way over to the Western world, is Akanamis. They creep out at night to lick the filth that accumulates in bathrooms. Their name literally means filth licker.
I bet if these...
Which kind of sounds dirty now that you mention it.
Actually, that dude, if they came over here, all the cleaning products and stuff like scrubbing bubbles would go out of business.
Scrubbing bubbles? Fuck that. I got a knocking on me. Anyway, they're supposed to appear like humanoid, but skin's gnarled and red like it stayed in a hot bath for like way too long. Oh, excuse me. It has a long pointed tongue, which I assume it uses to wrap around like the toilet.
Yeah. Well, it's pointed so it gets in the, you know, the crevices.
Yeah. You gotta get in the crevices, you know, make sure
it's real deep black.
You know, if you don't want to see this ghost, I guess you just keep your bathroom clean.
I guess. That's, you know, so it's weird, dude.
It's like kappas. I don't have this on my list, but you ever hear of a kappa?
Uh-uh.
They're like these Japanese water demons, and if you they'll come out and get you or whatever if you're being bad, if you're a little kid. But they have, like, these little balls of water on their head. So if you bow, they will bow back because they're some respectful-ass monsters. And then their magic water spills out, and then they turn to stone.
What the fuck?
Or you can bribe them with cucumbers to leave you alone, too.
Do they do a lot of tripping?
There's that. I want to know where the drug's at. Man. I'm going to Japan.
He's planning a trip, man. He's got to find out where they go. And I don't mean the kind that comes in a blue tablet.
Yeah, he's like, they ain't got Leatherface over there. I'll be fine.
All right, so here's another bathroom ghost. Is the Nopera Bo. And what it is it's a faceless guy. Like, he comes and his face is just like a smooth thing, no features, no eyes or anything. So some
it's
of
a hell
the,
of a poker face.
Yeah, and for some reason he appears in women's rooms.
So it's what happens over here in America all the time.
Speaking of which, this one's an international motherfucker because he manages to appear in Hawaii too, apparently.
Oh God, he travels.
So he'll pop up in a women's room, you know, in front of some Samoan bitch and be like, well, brother, what's up with the no face, man? They kind of just turned into a straight up Rasta voice.
Nah. We're fucking racist, motherfuckers.
We're really not. That's the sad part.
I know, we're really not. We're very bad at stereotyping.
We're sorry.
That did sound like a Rastafari. You get so close to Hawaiian.
I love how you take my botched voice and make it into racist. No, I'm just not that great at impressions. Fuck you.
That's what everyone does.
You use white toilet paper, you racist.
Okay, Jesse Jackson.
Yeah. Don't pick the blue one.
The blue pill.
Yeah.
All right, so our next and last bathroom ghost is Hanako. And this is probably like the most famous of the Japanese toilet ghosts. It's actually relatively benign. I'd be all right with this one. Basically, she's a scary thing Japanese kids dare each other to summon. It's kind of like a Bloody Mary.
Bloody Mary.
Yeah, yeah.
Scary Terry.
Teen Titans.
You watch way too many fucking cartoons. I have an excuse. I have kids. You're a grown man who lives alone.
Yeah, I am.
You get drunk and fucking eat cereal and watch cartoons.
Fuck yeah.
Bitches.
Anyway, so what they do is they knock on the stall door and say, "Are you there, Hanako-san?" To which she'll reply, or occasionally she'll be shown. So that's all that one is. So like, you'll knock on the door, she'll be like, "Yeah, I'm here." Okay.
And that's, yeah, you should have started off with that one, because that doesn't make me as horny as the other one.
Well, she's a little kid, so it might make you horny.
Nah.
You do live in Glenmar.
Yeah, that's true. Kentucky, USA. All
right, and here's the one I missed earlier because I was reading too fast and I'm being a fucking retard. This one's pretty good. Man, this one's hard to pronounce. Noopy PPO. N-U-P-P-O.
Is that the Japanese version of 3CPO?
It is spelled N-U-P-P-E-P-P-O.
Oh, my God. It's Noopy-P-P-O. Like Japanese Mississippi.
And basically what this thing is a walking blob of, like, rotten meat.
So my ex-girlfriend, basically.
It looks like a large, flabby, roughly humanoid chunk of flesh. Oh, it's like the size of a kid. It's got, like, lumpy, undeveloped hands and feet, and it's got, like, vaguely humanoid facial features.
Take my strong hand!
And they say it smells horrible. It's like the underside of an unwashed vagina.
Wait, there's an under. How big is these girls' vaginas' lips? There's an underside to a vagina?
Well, if there's a part that smells worse, it's the underside. So
have
anyway.
You ever seen the underside of a vagina, never. Terry? Yeah, never. What the fuck is that?
What? It's the underside.
It's the part down there by the taint.
Oh, okay.
Anyway,
so it's like the mud flap.
Yeah, it smells like that, like rotten meat.
Oh,
does that sound tasty to any of you guys?
Yeah, sure, man.
Why yeah. Not? Well,
you gotta try everything once, right?
Apparently, apparently, if you're fortunate enough to catch and eat one of these motherfuckers, you gain eternal youth.
Oh, that's a tough one. Do you think you could do that?
No.
See, here's the thing, though. You have to keep it down.
You have to keep it down. You can't puke.
You can't throw up. If you throw up, it doesn't work.
Yeah, I got to know what an underside of a vagina smells like, and then maybe. If it smells like rotten potatoes, I'm fucked. I hate rotten potatoes.
There's not much that smells
bad. Any you motherfuckers want to smell something shitty, smell fucking rotten potatoes. It is the worst fucking thing in the world. I could take puke. I could take blood. You know, what? But not rotten potatoes, man.
They would they do have a horrible smell.
Oh, it's fucking god-awful, man. Cause...
And these are actual ghosts that or at least that's what they're...
Yeah, it's like urban myth, like boogeyman, tooth fairy bullshit.
Son of a bitch, and they think I'm a stoner.
You're like, what fucking crazy motherfuckers came up with this shit?
Those motherfuckers!
Oh, man. A little something off topic then for Halloween, but I thought this was interesting. Me and Jay were talking about this the other day. So apparently, Ramin Noodles... Did you ever eat those, Terry?
Yeah, since we're talking about eating shit, right? Why not? Right?
Did you ever crunch them up, put them in a bowl, smoke the shit out of them?
Free base in the ramen, motherfuckers.
Snort the flavor packets at all? Well, some Chinese guy... Of course he's Chinese. I don't know why I said he was Chinese. his name is Dr. Brandon Kuo. I don't know how to say it. God, fucking names today. K-U-O of Massachusetts Quo? General Hospital. I don't know, Quo. He came up with a huge study, and he said that ramen noodles can cause Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. I am fucking scared. I know, dude. My whole childhood's ruined. I don't know why I said childhood.
Well, we're done.
Yeah, I still fucking eat them.
But so what causes it? Is it the flavor packet or
no? It's the preservatives and everything. It's called TBHQ. That sounds like something you smoke, right?
No, it does.
I need some of that
TBHQ. So it's not even the fucking like flavor packets.
No,
shit.
it's the coating in the noodles. I have some notes here that says what he found out. You can actually see a video. We'll link it down. They put a camera in your stomach, and they show that the ramen noodles don't dissolve; they just stay there. So you're like shitting out waves of ramen noodles. That's probably how they resell them. They just collect your shit. Like he got three bricks. Here's $50. Thanks. Come back again.
Jesus Christ!
But there's a preservative called TBHQ. Even after 2 hours in the stomach, they're still intact. Nothing even happens to them.
Now, I thought for sure what it would be is the gutter oil problem they have over there. I didn't think for it would be some sort of additive.
Yeah, it's the preservative, and it stresses the digestive system when it's in there. That like things aren't supposed to take 2 hours to break down. It makes the food last longer, but it ain't good for your poop system. Exactly. The TBHQ is safe for humans at 0.5 kilograms.
Okay, so how much is in these things?
It didn't say. Because they won't release it.
Oh, good.
But they say people can digest up to 100 kilograms of it a day because it's in everything, basically. It's in McDonald's chicken nuggets, Cheez-It crackers, most gum, popcorn, and KFC chicken. I'm pissed about the KFC chicken. Colonel Sanders, you lying motherfucker.
You know what? You know what? Let me get off on a rant here. Speaking of KFC, fuck KFC. And you know what?
Preach, man, preach.
Fuck KFC, and I'm going to tell you why. Every time I've ever gone to a KFC, maybe it's just my particular chain here, mm-hmm. but every time I've ever gone to a KFC, they have not once got the fucking order right. Not once! I've done the restaurant thing. I can forgive screwing up once in a while, but dude, not once!
What?
There's a little echo we got going on there, too.
What's usually wrong with it? They forget the little butter packets?
They forget something. They give me the wrong shit. Everything you could imagine that could possibly happen at a food place, they have fucked up.
I've never had that happen.
Not once have I gotten anything from KFC right. Not once. I've probably only gotten maybe five times.
They probably think you look like one of those Japanese monsters that are after legs. And they think you're after their chicken legs, and like, there he is. don't give him the right order. He won't come back. He'll get pissed at us.
I've probably only gone there maybe five times in my entire life just because they keep fucking up.
Mm-hmm. No, I crave KFC. That's why I was like, oh, man, I'll still eat this shit. I just thought it was fucking funny because, you know, you're going to be... All these college kids eat, you know, ramen noodles and all this stuff, and it's just like...
I knew people who didn't even cook them. They just crushed them up, sprinkled the flavor.
Yeah, I lived with a guy, he'd put peanut butter on the brick and just eat it. I'd be like, you sick motherfucker. He was also Jewish, and when he drank, we called him, he was drinking Hebrew. I don't know why that came up to mind, but I just... It sucks, because I'll still eat these motherfuckers.
Well, you know, they dry them out by deep frying them.
Yeah.
That's how they get the noodles dried out, is deep fry the shit
but
out of them.
But even if, like, say they get sued for this or something, it's the perfect crime. Because if it causes Alzheimer's disease, you won't remember that you got it. Ramen noodle people are like, good. And don't worry about us, you know, getting hate mail because they won't remember. But I could just, like, did Michael J. Fox eat these? Or, you know, it's that, who knows what, like, how much of this. And they said, oh, yeah, there was another thing. 5 kilograms has and can kill people. They have proof that it has killed people. Five kilograms. And you're supposed to have 0.5 a day.
Oh, good.
Yeah, and yeah, that's basically all that I wrote down that was... And like I said, we'll link it down. There's a video of a camera actually inside someone's stomach, and you can see the noodles trying to digest, and they're just... They look like... plain as day.
Oh, good.
Yeah, I love ramen noodles. I'll still eat the shit. I just hope it doesn't give me Parkinson's, because I'll be opening that pack and I'll be shaking. I'm like, shit.
Why's my beard shaking? I don't like my beard to shake.
Yeah, and then, you know, I'll be out in a job. The only job I can find is a wine-carrying, you know, server. I just can't.
Fucking spilling that shit everywhere.
Yeah, I just thought that was extra. It's off topic of the Halloween, but I thought it was pretty interesting.
Hey, fuck it. Why not?
Yeah.
Did you hear about the gutter oil thing they got going on? That's what I thought was going to be the problem.
Mm-mm.
Well, they have this big problem in China and Japan, I think, called gutter oil, and it's counterfeit cooking oil. but it was used for industrial purposes, and they bleach it so it looks clean. But it's,
oh god, it's so disgusting.
It's used dirty burnt oil.
What's it yeah. called again?
Gutter oil.
Doesn't that sound like a good death metal band? Gutter oil. Oh, that reminds me. I saw a thing today when I first woke up this morning. You know how they always make fun of Norwegian bands for being in the woods?
Mm-hmm.
There was an Instagram photo. It was obviously fake.
But oh, you're talking like, about the people who crashed the wedding photo.
Yeah. They were like, wedding photo accidentally crashes Norwegian death metal shoot. And it shows them in the middle of the woods.
Well, they got a ton of exposure from that.
Did they?
Yeah,
oh, that's hilarious.
Damn it, I wish I knew their name off the top of my head. I would give them a plug.
Oh, they actually got famous because of it.
Well, they're not famous, but, you know, people have been looking them up on YouTube and shit.
They actually know who they are now.
Yeah, yeah.
Were they were from Norwegian?
No, they're an American band.
I was just about to say, were they from Norwegia?
Norwegia.
Whatever works, man. Whatever gets you, you know...
Yeah, it was pretty cool. The
yeah, that's the photo actually right there.
Yeah, Cold Void. That's her name. Sorry,
Cold Void. Sounds like my life.
Cold Void. One word there. Yeah, they stumbled across the wedding photos and vice versa, and they all decided collectively, hey, let's do a photo together. So there's the most metal badass video or picture of these guys with the happy couple. And here's the best part. The guy's last name is awesome.
Get the fuck out of here.
I hope to God the woman took his last name.
Oh, dude, I would. Who wouldn't? She's a bitch if she didn't.
Yeah, really.
Dude, because you know what? They had to have done this. If they didn't, I'd be pissed. They should have played Everything is Awesome from the Lego movie. Everything is awesome. God, I wish mine had a cool... My last name sounds like a fucking vegetable.
Yeah, well, mine's a sport. Shut the fuck up. And not even a cool sport.
Yeah.
One that chicks in skirts play. All right, moving along. All right, so my next one, we get to talk about here is fun. So apparently we're going to like pull a Walmart here, and since it's our Halloween special, we're going to talk about Christmas.
Yeah, I was at Walmart last night, and there was Christmas decorations up already.
Oh, yeah, they're selling Christmas fucking all sorts of shit at this point.
I saw they had, like, this fake Santa sitting there, and I should have pulled a Terry and be like, motherfucker, beat the shit out of Santa. I'm always going to remember you now as the guy that beat up Leatherface and didn't get pussy.
It was weird.
No, I hope you dumped that bitch, man. If she didn't even get you puss after you beat up Leatherface.
What else does it take to get a
pussy? Jesus Christ.
Some guy's come at you with a fucking chainsaw and you kick his ass and you ain't going to get laid again?
Ungrateful.
Bitch, next time I'll let him get you.
Unforgivable.
Those motherfuckers!
I like that sound clip. Can you tell?
I fucking love it.
All right, so we have a Christmas sex robot festival.
Oh, here we go.
Okay, so here's the deal. They're having an international conference about sex on robots. Because if we come up with some sort of technological wonder like artificial intelligence, the first thing everybody thinks is, can I fuck it?
Exactly. That's where I'm going.
I like you. You can come over to my house and fuck my sister.
You know, what the hell? Let's fuck the Terminator.
Instead of saying, I'll be back, it's like, get on your back.
Drip, drip, bitch. So, anyway, Malaysia banned this thing. They were originally going to do it in Malaysia, and they banned it. So, they're doing it in London. You know, you think of the fucking Brits as all sophisticated and shit, yeah. And they're having a sex... fucking sex robot festival. Man.
They're like, yes, I liked the noise it makes when it jerks my penis.
Yes, quite. Yeah. Reginald!
Indubitably.
Reginald, please fetch my sex robot.
How much is that robot? $1,000. Rubbish!
Oh, my God. So top academics in the field of robotics and human-computer interaction are going to come together and talk about fucking robots.
This is beautiful. These are my kind of people. How about it, Terry?
I guess the future is artificial sex. I mean, it would prevent, it would pretty much end the abortion argument right there, wouldn't it?
Yeah,
you
that's
can't
true.
Knock up a fucking robot.
And even if it did, the robot could just beep through hanger. You don't have to go to Walmart and buy a hanger quick. I was actually going to be an aborted baby for the show, but I didn't want a hanger on my head the whole show.
Thanks for not doing
that. Yeah, no problem, no problem. Go ahead, Jay, sorry.
Oh my God.
You're even worse for playing that, you sick son of a bitch.
I didn't play nothing. It came out of the ether.
Yeah.
All right, so anyway, there's this chick called Dr. Kate Devlin, and she is apparently a sex robot expert.
Experts? Oh, this is great.
Apparently there is. Ugh. And she's hosting the event, and she wrote a book called In Defense of Sex Robots.
Ugh, God.
See, you keep thinking I'm just calling them sex robots. No, she called them
I'm glad
robots.
It's a woman, though, because it's sort of turning me on, but go ahead.
I didn't see a picture of her. It might not be worth it.
Yeah. She grabs, like, Dorito face.
That's a huge bitch.
Watch, she's fucking sexy as hell.
Yeah, I know she probably is.
I have no idea.
She probably is.
Anyway, she says, I think robots could become our lovers in the future. Does love have to be reciprocated in order to be valid? I don't know, but it's kind of nice. Otherwise, yeah. It's called stalking.
Yeah.
Anyway, sessions are... I wish they had chosen a different word, but sessions are planned on humanoid robots, robot emotions, and personalities, and I shit you not, this is a word. Teledildonics.
Oh, my God.
Teledildonics?
Teledildonics.
Sounds like a type of weed. Me and Terry just on it today.
Obviously. But yeah, teledildonics. This is the study.
Teledildonics works for me.
It's a study of cyber sex toys, apparently. All right, so they also have things on intelligent electronic sex hardware, entertainment robots, and more. And I'm talking too much, so now I'm yawning. Sorry. It's not even that I'm tired. I just talk too much. Research presented at the Congress will be reviewed and compiled in a special issue of the Journal of Computer Science. So they're getting this shit published.
Oh, my goodness.
This is a real science-y thing.
We got to look this bitch up.
Go for it. You got a computer in front of you? Kate Devlin's her name.
Kate Devlin. Mm. That sounds good. Mm.
Devlin dismissed early calls to ban sex robots and believes people not need to have an open mind to the possibility of sex machines playing a constructive role in society.
An open mind. I just picture the robot putting his finger over your mouth. Just let it happen.
You know what? This actually does bring up an interesting topic, though. The whole sex with robots thing. If you're a fucking freak who's got, like, pedophile tendencies or something like that, could they just make you a robot and that be therapeutic to keep you from doing dumb shit?
Yep. I know exactly where you're coming from. That who knows?
It might be a good way to solve the problem.
Yeah, because I was just reading about how this person was saying that sex robots, they're getting so good, they're actually worried about the future of the human race because they're getting so good that people might not reproduce. And I don't blame you. Talking to people sucks.
But not everybody hates everyone, Casey.
Yeah, but I do, so, you know. Everyone hates everyone. I'm just the only one who admits it.
You're not the only one who admits it. I don't like anybody either, but I like you people.
We present the Board of Badasses. These people make this show possible.
Hey everyone, I want to take a minute to talk about our Board of Badasses. These people make this show possible, just like the promo said. Firstly, we have KP Smith. Casey?
Yeah.
KP Smith. He's been providing constructive feedback from the start, so thank you.
Yes, thanks, man. You've been awesome. Giving us a lot of constructive criticism, helping us get better.
Especially focusing more on the alcohol we're drinking that day, yes. So that we can be beer raiders instead of drunks. So yes. Thank you for that.
At 10 in the morning.
At 10 in the morning.
Thanks.
And secondly, we have our friend Jason.
Yep.
Throw him up on the board. Jason.
And he will be on the show at some point. We'll get him on here.
Jason would be the surly satellite installer.
Yes. K can't wait for him to get on. It's going to be fun.
Yeah. he's been giving us constructive feedback along the way, too. What works, what doesn't work. So we thank you. And if you want to be on our wall of badasses, you can become a patron on patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. If you pledge as little as the cost of a venti pumpkin spice latte, you can end up on our board right there. Every dollar goes into being able to help us bring you a better show, better production qualities, better cameras, better equipment. So if you want to have a better show, go to patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions, and we'll see you on the board of badasses.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. With that being said, we're going to get on to our game.
Yes, we have something special planned for. This is the first time since we have a guest. We can't really play Jay versus Casey. That'd sort of be unfair. So what's going to happen is I found 10 things on the internet that you can actually buy. They're fucking weird as shit. I can't believe you can buy these things. And what's going to happen is you're going to write these on the card that I gave you, and you're going to show them to the camera. So write them nice and
big. We're going to write what?
The price.
So we're doing like a knockoff prices, right?
Yes.
Do we have to spay and neuter our animals?
Yeah, sure. I forgot my tiny penis microphone.
Hell, and I then, like you. You can come over to my house and fuck then, my sister.
But you can't go over, though. You can't go over. And I'm
okay,
keep
closest square. Without going over. So
shit,
we're...
I forgot a pen. Where's that pen at?
I don't have a pen.
There's a pen. I'll keep track somehow. Fuck your pen. Yeah, fuck my pen.
Still right. Terry's marker.
Yeah, I'm just going to borrow your marker. Everyone's about. All right. So the first thing we have here, let me zoom in on this, is a unicorn poop scarf.
I don't know what the fuck it is, but I want one.
Yeah. For people listening to our podcast stuff, we'll try to explain this stuff the best we can, and we'll put pictures on YouTube.
It's a little stuffed unicorn with a scarf coming out of its ass.
Yeah,
and a rainbow color.
Like, you'll get kicked out of school if you wear this, kids. Don't, you know, if you're a kid listening to this, you shouldn't be. Anyways, where's your parents?
This so seems like something that would be in the early days of the internet, like right up there with Hamster Dance.
Yeah, exactly. So go ahead and write on the card, nice and big, what you think the price of this is without going over. Is a unicorn poop scarf.
Unicorn rainbow poop scarf.
Go ahead, Terry. Right. Show us what you got. You think it's $10.95. What do you think, Jay?
I'm going with $14.99.
$14.99. Let me check here on my handy dandy notebook.
Oh, God.
You won't believe this shit. It's $44.99.
So did I win that one?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yay.
Mario Marketer. Yeah. Oh, man.
So this thing is fucking
$50? Yeah, can you believe that shit?
It looks like a $2 stuffed animal and a fucking something that my kid would sketch.
I know, it looks like a homeless guy made it.
Hey, don't knock the homeless, man. Rudy Giuliani had him killed.
All right, so let's get to the next one here. This is a picture of a toy you could buy.
The fuck is that?
Wow.
This is a creeping, peeping Tom prank toy. You can put it on your window. It's like a decal, and it looks like someone's looking in your window.
My God.
That is fucked up.
You didn't want to sleep tonight, did you, Terry?
Oh, he's sleeping tonight. Doing those drugs.
Doing them drugs, man. Yo, let me get that toy, man.
So go ahead, Terry. How much do you think? $40? $40. What do you think,
$40, Jay? $40, man. I'm going to go cheap. I'm going $5.99.
The price is $48.23.
Are you kidding me?
I swear to God, dude. That's expensive to stalk someone.
I can stalk somebody for fucking free.
Oh, man. All right. So
Jesus Christ.
It only takes $40 to stock something. All
right. My God. Yeah.
So the third one we got here is just for the straight-up alcoholics.
You rang?
Yeah. We got a pair of boxers with a little slit in front of that. The
with a flask?
With a zipper so you could put your flask in it so you can sneak it into places.
I just had to go to a wedding recently. I got to use that.
Yeah,
fucking
exactly.
Thing.
How much do you think these boxer flask pants are?
Whatever it is, I'll pay it. All right, don't mind our writing sounds.
Go ahead, Terry. How much do you think this is? $35? $10.99. The price of the secret pocket boxer briefs is $23.95.
I win.
Jay wins something. Woo! Sorry, I have to keep Barney Barker. I completely fucking lost my pen. I gave it to a sex robot. All right. Oh, man. Okay,
I'd say fuck that robot, but you probably would.
Yeah, exactly. All right, number four here. We have a beer cannon.
wait a minute. What?
A beer cannon.
So does this shoot out like cans of beer?
Cans of beer. Like when Bubba needs a beer and he's 50 miles away, you got him. You got to handle him. Yo, Jeb, I'm about to beat my wife. I need a beer.
God damn it, Bernice. I said to get back in the house.
Exactly. That thing looks high-tech.
You're going to kill somebody with that thing.
Dude, it has like laser sights.
Man, I'm gonna go high on this one. Jesus,
Terry, don't
Christ.
Get excited. You said the word high. Go ahead, Terry. Show us what you think. 25 bucks.
I'm going $99.99.
Jay, you were closer. It was 398.
Woo! Yeah. When you gotta get drunk, absolutely right the fuck yeah, now. You need to spend $300
in a heartbeat. In a heartbeat.
God damn.
All right, the next one, because America, why the fuck not, is a
America, fuck yeah,
is a steering wheel tray for your food.
Can I get one after the show?
Yes. And of course, since it's America, there's McDonald's on it.
Fuck yeah, what the hell else would you do?
I don't even know how it works. Like, you're going to spill your fucking food. How much do you think this steering wheel tray is? Go ahead, Terry. Show us what you got. $7?
$10.99.
Jay, you were close. It was $13.99.
Yeah. I got the. Oh.
Yeah, that was cool. Actually, one tastes like McDonald's. All right. So far with five of them, we have Jay with four, Terry with one.
Fuck yeah.
Fucking Jay Bob Barker in this. All right.
Spare new to your animals, please.
For number six, we have a beer koozie, but this is no ordinary beer koozie. It is a counting beer koozie. So
you keep track of just how drunk you are?
Yeah, it's a koozie with a digital interface so you can tell when you can drink and drive legally.
Wow.
I don't know
who gives a shit?
I don't know what the America theme is here, but this shit is so American. It's ridiculous.
American as fuck.
Yeah, like, when you go over your limit, it should make a noise like an American eagle going,
so just go, grab her by the pussy.
Grab by the pussy. What do you think, Jay? What do you think this was worth?
$5.
$5? Make you holla?
$51
bucks? It's $10.99.
Oh.
Oh, man. It's now 5-1, Jay.
Damn.
Terry, I don't take this too literally, but I think you're going a little too high on these prices.
On our practice round, I think we learned some shit here.
All right, number seven. This is for all you ladies. Lightsaber dildos. I like it how they're just blurred out. Like,
wow, 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 wow.
Hey, look, there's a blue and a red one. I wonder if you get your skin cut off or you get choked if you pick one of those.
Is it Kylo Ren and going to get all fucking upset?
Yeah, you know about it. They didn't pick the red one.
Oh, I don't want to be in a vagina.
Go ahead, Jay. How much do you think these are?
$10.99.
Terry, $7. They are I'm not even joking about this. $169. Wow.
I won, but I don't feel good about it.
How about it?
You know they threw that 69 in there. They're like, fuck
what
it.
What the fuck? It's like a shitty plastic dildo.
Oh, man.
I want one with a pull start.
Yeah. Is it regular or diesel? This is for, this is another American type motherfucking thing. This lazy fucking shit. It's a head hammock. A head hammock.
You know what? Wow. I can see a purpose for this. I really can.
I know, but dude, she looks like she's roofied.
Dude. Yeah. Come on, man. I go on long trips with my kids sometimes, my wife. Sometimes she falls asleep in the passenger seat. I'd rather that than her head flopping around.
Well, you have
kids.
That's when you need baseball bats and chloroform, but that's a different story.
Are you Casey fucking Anthony?
Casey Anthony, that.
fucking Nancy Grace in it here.
How much do you think this head hammock is?
I don't know. This is a goddamn genius invention.
It's a girl in a seat, and she has this thing basically tied around her neck. It looks like a gag toy, and it's just not going to do. Go ahead, Terry. Show us how much you think this is. $30?
$25. Yeah.
$25. The price of the head hammock, I can't say a fuck word today, is $25.
Damn!
Jay got it right on.
Woo!
Wow. Right on. Man, you're fucking killing you. Killing you. Casey Anthony, yeah.
I lost the practice round, yeah. So I'll take it.
7-1. All right, number 9. Number 9, we have a mold that makes poop for your Play-Doh.
Oh, wow.
I like the nuts in it. It's somewhat old fluorescent.
I think it's supposed to be corn.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Fluorescent Play-Doh up and made like corn for the poop.
That's the way to do it.
Yeah, poop Play-Doh molds. I like how in the mold there's even a mold for the corn kernels.
That's the way we do it. Yeah. Monte Williams shit.
Go ahead, Terry. What do you think this is worth? $12?
$7.99.
The Play-Doh poop mold is $7.96.
Oh, we both went over.
Did you go over, Terry? What was it? Yeah, okay. All right, so it's still 7
to 1. Oh, damn.
All right.
Damn.
You basically already won, Jay, but we'll do the last two just
fuck
for fun.
Fuck it, I want to play.
This one is some
what
sick motherfucker.
Fuck?
It is an umbilical cord iPhone charger.
Dude, that's badass.
I know. It's an iPhone umbilical cord charger cable.
Whatever it is, it's not enough.
Yeah, it's just ridiculous. It looks like an umbilical cord, and it hooks up to your... It basically eats your phone, if you can see the picture. How much you guys think this... Oh, I have your marker. Shit. $30. I think this is Terry. 40?
40.
You'll be surprised about this. $6,000.79. I'm not even joking.
Yeah. I mean, I like it, but I don't like down payment on a car like it.
Dude, and this is like one of the, you can buy robots on this site.
Sex robots.
Yeah, sex robots. So, yeah, that price is so outrageous. Who's close to that, actually?
Terry won, but
oh, Terry.
It wasn't by a wide margin.
Yeah, it wasn't by... All right, we had a tiebreaker just in case, but we'll just do this for fun. I don't even know why this exists. It's a Q-tip crossbow.
What the fuck?
I want one. Yeah.
When you're launching beers at people and they need clean ears, this site's got you.
Got that from ThinkGeek, didn't you?
No.
That's a ThinkGeek kind of thing.
No, it's some site called Waste Your Time or WasteYourMoney.com or something like that.
Well, that makes sense.
Yeah, Terry, go ahead and show us what you got. $17. $19. It is $9.99.
Oh, Terry. You suck.
Oh, you put seven. What'd you put? 17?
17.
You put $7.99?
17. Neither one of us got a point on that one.
All right, so I guess that is Jay as the winner. 7-2.
Damn!
And we actually have a prize for you. It is a box of half-eaten nerds I found in a van with no windows outside. So go ahead. I don't know if they're roofied or... I know, man. They're so delicious. They're so delicious. So I think that went pretty well. How about you guys?
Oh, yeah.
First time we ever had a guest.
I got nerds in my mouth.
Make sure they're legal age. So that's
I like
it.
The bitches with the glasses.
So, yeah, thank you everyone again. That's for our Halloween special. Gotta get the mileage out of that. So, tune in next week. We release new episodes every Thursday, and we'll see you later. Thank you. Thank you, Terry, for coming.
Now remember, if you like what we do, be sure to like the channel,
mm-hmm.
subscribe to it. If you're on YouTube, make sure you hit the little bell so you get notifications about every time we post a new video.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still eating nerds. If you like our show and you want to support us, please go to patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. Thank you very much. We appreciate it. We love you. See you next Thursday.
Thank you.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.